The vast majority of the text of this film was taken from the Willowtown walking tour guide.
American people, and you may be sure that they will not stop short of the goal.
Promenade for pedestrians on top, local traffic on the bottom, and two one-way expressways in between. Here is four-story proof that our modern highway planners, with imagination and public support, can solve our traffic problems.
The Belgium block surface of Joralemon is one of the few surviving streets of its kind in New York. The tunnel for the 4 and 5 subway lines runs under Joralemon. Pairs of the houses on Joralemon stair-step down the hill, each pair 30 inches lower. 57, 55, 53, and 45 Joralemon Street were all formerly owned by one of Willowtown's more eccentric residents, the late Abram O. Jarber, a plumber. Abram put the name Cozy Nook over the doorway to 57. 44, 42, and 40 Joralemon Street are three of Willowtown's 12 smaller brick clapboarded houses. This role was the setting for the 2004 psychological thriller, The Forgotten, starring Julianne Moore. Joralemon, among Willowtown's new contemporary houses, is on a site which had a series of bars, one of which served as a setting in Woody Allen's movie, Bullets Over Broadway, in 1994. This New York City station pumped both salt water from the East River and fresh water from city mains to fight fires in tall buildings. It was phased out in 1954 following the introduction of fire engine super pumpers. The building sat empty until the 1970s, when it was converted into a six-family co-op called the Heights Mews. The Riverside houses were built in 1889-90. They are an early model for better housing for the urban poor. Far ahead of its time, the project had its own park, playground, bathhouse, and music pavilion. Jacob Riis once said of White's projects, "They are like a big village of contented people who live in peace with one another
because they have elbow room."
The original U-shaped nine-unit complex had 280 two-to-four-room apartments. The west section along Furman Street was demolished in the late 1940s to make room for the Brooklyn-Queens Expressway. number 7, 9, 11, and 13 Columbia Place are survivors of 9 such houses known as Cottage Row. All 4 have been extensively renovated inside. 2527 Columbia Place was called Columbia House when built in 1905 to provide more space for the school in the former Willow Place Chapel. The addition also served as a clubhouse for the children who lived in the Riverside houses. In the deadly flu epidemic of 1918, it became a call center for medical help, food, and other relief. Mickle's Garden, on the southwest end of the block, is named for Mitchell Mickle Minowar, who lived at 10 Columbia Place and lovingly kept a plot in this community garden developed in the late 1990s. Palmito Playground and Dog Run, where Columbia Place meets State Street, was once filled with houses on Columbia Place that went through to Atlantic and State Street through to the waterfront docks. The houses were demolished for the BQE. The first park that opened in 1947 was called the Atlantic Playground, and with its redevelopment completed in 1999, became the Palmito Playground. Montero Bar and Grill at 73 Atlantic Avenue is the last remnant of 50 years ago when bars and restaurants lined both sides of the avenue and this corner of Willowtown was all Spanish. Montero's is more or less as it was when it opened in 1947 and is still run by a member of the Montero family. The inside is decorated with ship models and paintings of Spain. 322-324 Hick Street, a recently completed six-family condo, is distinguished by its V-shaped facade and triangular bay windows. 314 Hick Street is presently one of the last empty lots in Willowtown. Numbers 291 and 293 Hick Street on the east side and numbers 276, 278, 280, 282, and 284 on the west side are 7 of a cluster of a dozen carriage houses and stables built in Willowtown between 1870 and 1887. All but 2 survive as private residences. The 5 on the west side are backed up by 3 on Willow Place. Three-story number 282 Hicks was the home of the American painter Albert J. Pucci, who did striking still lifes, landscapes, and portraiture. His widow, Goris, continues to live there. Number 278 Hicks was the former carriage house of Alfred T. White. Number 276 Hick Street was the former studio of William Zorich, a Lithuanian-American sculptor, painter, and watercolors. The head of a woman on the dormer was placed there by Zorich himself. Alfred Palmer, the previous owner, was an eccentric who apparently hoarded many artifacts and stored them at 280 Hicks. This building will probably be gutted and the interior redesigned by the new owner.